Good morning, everyone. Good morning, people of God. Good morning, Rock Church Kent. This morning, I want us to read one of, you know, the last Psalm 150 from verse 1 to 6. It says, praise ye the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in the firmament of his power, praise him for his mighty acts, praise him according to his excellent greatness, praise him with the sound of the trumpet, praise him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise him with the timbrel and the dance. Praise him with string instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise him, the Lord. This one, I want us to open our mouths and praise him. I want you to praise him. This is we are under the firmament of the heavens. We have breath in us. You know, we're meant to be praising with every instrument, with every timbrel, with every under of our pots, and hitting and praising God this morning. I want us to exalt him for life, for health, for strength, for his mercies, for his goodness. I want us to open our mouth and praise him this morning. I want us to praise him like the psalmist endears us to praise him. Song was playing on the background before, Bridget, one of my favorite songs that would be played in the car, taking us, you know, to meeting places. We just lift his name on high, praise him, exalt him, worship him, love him this morning, love him for life, this 16th day of November. Love, let everything that have breath love him. Let's exalt him, let's praise him, let's magnify him this morning. Oh, my sister, my brother, open your mouth and just worship the King of glory, the great I am. Let's just bless him. After all of the writings of the psalm, he ends the whole book with 149 verses, which is 150th chapter, saying, praise ye the Lord. After all of the of telling God, of, you know, talking to God through the Psalms, praising him, telling of his ordeals, asking him to fight those that fight against him in Psalm 35, talking about so many stories and so many visions captured, the psalmist ends the book of Psalms in the 150th chapter, saying, praise ye the Lord, praise him. As long as we have the ability to be in his sanctuary, our lives should be that sanctuary, our homes should be that sanctuary. Open your mouth this morning and just praise him this morning, praise him, exalt him, love him, magnify him this morning. This is a privilege to be counted amongst the living. You know, early in the morning, would we rise, just like the psalmist says, and give praise to the God that is due to his name. Open your mouth this morning and just worship him. Worship him, my brother, my sister. Oh, my brazandilikia. Lord, I thank you for life. I thank you for health. I thank you for breath. I thank you for your message, for your goodness. I thank you, Lord King of glory, for the things you are doing in Rock Church Kent. I thank you because you are prompt to answer the prayers of your people. I thank you because you're not bereft of blessings upon your people. I want to just thank him. This morning, open your mouth. Pastor Shola has been declaring the power of creativity and upon Rock Church. Let's open up and just worship him this morning, that he has given us such creative ideas. And I'm sure many of us have barely slept last night because of the things God is dropping in our spirit man so that we can do and achieve. And I'm saying, is this lifetime enough to do what God has put in our hearts to do? Let's open our mouth and just bless him and just thank him and just magnify him and love him this morning. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ever ask or imagine or even think, with the power that is at work within us. That power is at work within you, my sister, my brother. That power is at work within you. Open your mouth this morning and just worship him. That power is at work within you. Oh, Father, I give you praise. I just love you this morning. Lord, we bless you. All heaven and earth declare your glory. The sun, moon, and stars give you praise. Father, we want to join, yes, the elders and the angels that continually bow to say, holy, holy is the Lord God of hosts. Yes, my life is full of your glory. Just the way the heaven and earth is full, my life is full of your glory. My thoughts are full of your glory. My expressions are full of your glory. Like, even when I want to complain, before I open my mouth, I say the 100 things you have done, the victories you have wrought, the deliverances. I cannot but just swallow and say, Lord, you are awesome. Lord, you are mighty. Lord, you say, when men are crying, there's a casting down. I have no experience but to say that you're lifting up. But because of respect of what, you know, of their experiences, you just say, God, you've been good. You know, just not counting your gains, things to make them feel, oh yes, I've been left out. But in your heart, you're just saying, God, you've been good. Father God, I worship you this morning. I give you praise. I thank you, Lord King. I can gather with like-minded people in people's families, be in their airspace at this early time, worshiping the great I am, the Lord of hosts, that we can increase voices together and bless the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Father, I worship you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I just magnify you this morning. I thank you, Lord. There are so many things that I have struggled with at this time, but not with worshiping you, not with praising you, not with exalting you, not with loving you. Father, Lord, I want to thank you. You said time will not be enough to tell of your goodness, to sing of your mercies, to talk of your deliverances, to talk of your favors. Oh, Father, we worship you this morning. I don't know who is in the same mind with me this 16th day of November 2020, just to worship the great I am, the King of glory, the one that sits over the circles of the earth, the one that watches over his every word to perform it, the one that is the ruler to the ends of the creator, not the Lord of hosts, the man of war, the one that is Jehovah all by himself, that he doesn't need me to add to who he is or to add to the glory that he has. But because he so loves us and has engraved me in the hollow of his palm, let's open our mouth this morning and just worship him. Father, I've come with a heart of gratitude. I've come with a heart of thanksgiving. I've come with a heart. Father, Lord, it's like the psalm, it says, search me, O Lord, and try me. If there be any iniquity in my heart, I want us to open our heart and open ourselves before him this morning. Sweet Holy Spirit, is there any girl, any guys in us? Father, Lord, I lift up myself before you. I ask, Lord, begin to search through me. I do that in the night. I say, Lord, is there anything in me that will not give you glory, that at the appearance of Jesus, I will be ashamed? Anything, King of glory, O God. Oh, my brother, Father, Lord, begin to reveal it to us. So that, yes, O God, so that by your spirit, by your word, you begin to sanctify us by your truth. Your word indeed is truth. Open your mouth this morning and ask him for that sanctification. The power to sanctify is on this platform. I want us to open our mouths this morning. Oh, yes, wherever you're listening from, the power to sanctify is on this morning altar. Open your mouth and ask the King of glory, the sweet Holy Spirit. That is what's his specialty. One of the specialties of the Holy Spirit is the ability to sanctify. So this morning, Lord, as we raise our worship to him, as we raise our praise to him, as we give him every accolade that is due to him, as we recognize what he is doing in our midst, oh, my brother, they're asking for to sanctify. King of glory, Rock of Ages, I ask you, Lord, sanctify us, O God, true and true. Your word is truth. You've given us that truth to sanctify us, O God. Father, Lord, we thank you as we look through your word, O God. Let the truth of your word sanctify this morning. Oh, Father, we bless you. We magnify you this morning. Cleanse us by your word. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Over to you, pastors.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. I hope everyone can hear me this morning.
Yes, Pastor.
Father, we thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's a beautiful week. It's the start of a glorious week. And we just glorify the name of Jesus. And we acknowledge him. Thank you very much, Sister Uju. Thank you so much for the opening prayer. How many of you are excited that this week is going to be a week of progress? How many of you are excited that this week God is moving you forward? How many of you are excited that this week God's going to do great and mighty things in your lives? If you're happy, just open up your mouth right now and begin to say, Father, I bless you and I thank you for the great things that would happen in my life this week. I thank you for the great things that you would do through me and in me this week. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. This is a week of a lifting. This is a week of increase. This is a week that I'm going to press ahead. This is a week that I'm going to press forward. This is a week that I'm going to move forward in the name of Jesus. So let's begin to bless the name of Jesus and thank him for the whole of this week. Begin to glorify his name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Masa talaba katushke debo sike nebra hande ke debo zike reba sata laba hande. Father, we thank you. This week, there is a lifting awaiting you. This week, there is a lifting that's waiting for you. This week, there is a way forward that's waiting for you. And it's a way forward of favor. It's a way forward of a fulfillment of a heart's desire. It is a way forward of answered prayers. This week, it's a way forward for you in the name of Jesus. So begin to thank God. Begin to thank God because he has gone ahead of you this week. His angels have gone ahead of you this week. His goodness has gone ahead of you this week. His faithfulness has gone ahead of you this week. In the name of Jesus, this week will be a week to remember. It's going to be a week to remember. Masete lebra hande ke yedebo. It's going to be a week to remember. If you're on this platform this morning, this week is going to be a week to remember for you. This is going to be a week of a memorial for you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In this week, great and mighty things will be accomplished in your life. In this week, great and mighty things the Lord will do. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and we honor you for this great week. We thank you for this beautiful week. It's a week like no other. It's a week that we're going to press forward. It's a week that we're going to step forward. It's a week that we're going to move forward. It's a week that we're going to press ahead. We are pressing ahead this week. We are pressing ahead this week. In the name of Jesus. And I have a word for someone this morning. I have a word of restoration. I have a word of restoration for someone this morning. There's someone or there are a few people on this platform. You've been fighting for something. You've been fighting and it looks like the more you fought for it, it looks like the more it didn't seem like it was going to work out. But the Lord is asking me to say to you this morning that there is going to be restoration. There is going to be restoration. He says your fight will not be in vain in the name of Jesus. Whatever you're fighting for, whatever you're trusting God and fighting for, the Lord asked me to tell you that it's not going to be in vain. You will not fight in vain. You're not going to beat as one that beats the air, but you're fighting and the Lord is going to bring restoration. The Lord in his own time, his own due season, a restoration is coming your way in the name of Jesus Christ. If you believe that, just say amen wherever you are. I believe that there's restoration coming for me. The things that I have lost, the joy that I have lost, the peace that I have lost, the lifting that I have lost, the things that have the devil has stolen from me. Every single thing that the devil has stolen from me, I receive my restoration now. Come and open up your mind and say, Lord, I thank you because you're bringing restoration. Declare that you receive your restoration now. Come and open up your mind and declare it yourself. Speak it forth that you receive your restoration now. I receive my restoration now. According to the order of God, I receive my restoration. Restoration in my finances. Restoration in my home. Restoration in my marriage. Restoration in my business. Restoration in my walk with God. I receive restoration. Every scheme of Satan, every deceit from the pit of hell, every manipulation that Satan has used to try to hold me down, that he has cheated me with, right now the Lord is overturning it by his power and the force of his goodness that's working for me this week. The Lord is overturning it and I am receiving my restoration in the name of Jesus. I am receiving my restoration and that restoration will bring you rest. Come on, open up and say, Lord, I receive my rest. Through the restoration you're bringing my way, I receive that rest for this week. I receive that rest for this week. I will not struggle this week. I will not panic this week. I will not be confused this week. I receive that rest. I receive the wind that changes the tide of things. The wind of God that will blow into your situation. The wind of God that will blow into your circumstance. That will bring about a change and a tide and a turnaround. I receive it and I welcome it into my life. I welcome it into my home. We welcome it into Rock Church. The tide of change. We welcome it now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you because we receive the change. We receive restoration. We receive restoration. We receive restoration in the name of Jesus. In those things that have been stolen from us. In those things that has been deprived, that we've been deprived of. That's been your promises to us. That's been what you wanted to do in our lives. But somehow the enemy has succeeded in cheating us of them. Therefore, right now, in the name of Jesus, we receive restoration. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we bless you. Father, we thank you. Because you are so faithful, oh God. Even in things that I've forgotten about. Some of the things that you've forgotten about, the Lord's going to awaken your spirit to them and he's going to bring restoration. The things that you're thinking, well, maybe that's my lot in life. God is saying, I'm going to turn it around. I'm going to reverse the whole thing. I will reverse it in your favor. Everything that's been going out against you, against your peace, against your joy, God is reversing in your favor. This week, God is reversing them in your favor. This week, God is announcing a reversal of the things that the enemy has turned against you in the name of Jesus, that there shall be what? A reversal. And there shall be what? Restoration. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for restoration. Father, we bless you for restoration. We give you all the praise. And so this week, you are going to move forward. Because moving forward is a must as a child of God. Journeying with God means that we will be moving most of the time under the leading of the Holy Spirit. So this week, you are not permitted to move backwards. It is a forward movement. It is a progressive movement that's coming upon you this week by the power of the Holy Spirit. It is a progressive movement in the name of Jesus. You are moving forward. Open up your mouth and say, Lord, I am moving forward. Speak to the elements and say, elements, I thank you because you're moving me forward. Speak to the earth and say, earth, I thank you because you're yielding your goodness. You're yielding your favor. You're yielding fruits unto me. You're yielding progress. You're yielding. The earth cannot work against you. The Bible says when we praise the Lord, the Bible says the earth shall yield its fruits unto us. So the earth is yielding its fruits unto you this week. As you're lifting up your voice in honor of the King of Kings, the maker of the heavens and the earth, because you are moving forward this week. Your business receives promotion. Your life receives promotion. Your home receives promotion. Everything you touch receives a moving forward in the name of Jesus. Not a moving backwards, but a moving forward in the name of Jesus. The shackles of Satan are broken. The hold of the enemy are broken. Even in your mind. So for some of you, it might be that your mind has been teaching. Satan has succeeded in filling your mind up with things that tells you that you are not going to move forward, that nothing good can come out of you. I tell you something, lots of good things are going to come out of you this week. In the name of Jesus, lots of good things are going to come out of you this week. In the name of Jesus, the Lord's wisdom will overshadow you. Just like when Mary asked the angel, he said, angel, how is this going to be? Seeing that I know no man. He said, the power of the Almighty God will overshadow you. He said, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. This week, the Holy Spirit will come upon you in a unique way. This week, the Holy Spirit will come upon you in an unusual way. And the power of the Almighty will overshadow you. So that whatever you say, whatever you think, whatever you reason out, however way you plan your days in this week, will be days of progress, will be days of progress in the name of Jesus. Because it is not your mind planning it, it is the mind of God planning for you. It is the mind of God injected into your spirit. It is the wisdom of God. It is the creativity of God. Every step you take this week will be meaningful steps. In the name of Jesus. Every step you take this week will be meaningful. In the name of Jesus. No step taken this week will go to waste. No step taken this week will go to waste. In the name of Jesus Christ. So this morning, you are receiving the divine ability. You are receiving the strength. You are receiving the wisdom and the understanding of the Holy Ghost. You know how to handle effectively every season of your life. In this week is a season. The season of this week, the wisdom, the strength, the ability, the understanding to handle this week effectively rest upon you right now in abundance in the name of Jesus. You will not be cheated this week. Rather, favor will show forth on your behalf this week. You will not be cheated this week. Everything that you planned to do, everything that you've risen out by the help of the Holy Spirit, you will accomplish them this week in the name of Jesus. Nothing will hold you back. Nothing will sit down in the name of Jesus Christ. Just like Paul said in Philippians chapter 3, from verse 13 to 15, that he does not count himself to have apprehended, but this one thing he does, he forgets the things that are behind and he reaches forth unto those things which are before. This week he will reach forth unto those things that are before. In other words, the things that have been planned by God for him, the things that have been placed in front of him by God to accomplish and to achieve. He said, I'm reaching forth to them. You're reaching forth to those things right now in the name of Jesus. You're reaching forth to those things right now in the name of Jesus. All everything that the Lord
has positioned you for divinely for this week, you will accomplish in the name of Jesus. Not one of them will you not accomplish. You will accomplish them to the glory of God and to the shame of the devil. He said, I reach forward unto those things that are before, and I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. This week, you're going to press ahead. By the help of the Holy Spirit, you're pressing ahead. By the function of the Holy Spirit, you're pressing ahead. By the unction of the Holy Spirit, you're pressing ahead. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, you're pressing ahead. In the name of Jesus. And everything you press into this week will answer to you. It will answer to you according to the order of the Spirit, according to the patterns of the Holy Ghost, according to the path that has been created for you this week. The Bible says that the steps of the righteous are ordered of God. Yes, this week your steps are ordered. This week your steps are ordered. And God leads you to progress. God leads you to prosperity. That is your portion this week in the name of Jesus Christ. He says, yes, for the price of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. The calling of God upon your life, you're pressing higher this week. Hallelujah. Because it's a high calling. You are pressing higher this week. You are pressing higher this week. So it's a time to reconsolidate your trust in God. It is a time to reconsolidate your trust in God. Because God is asking you to get ready. He's saying, get ready, get ready, get ready. For this week is going to be a week like never before. Get ready, get ready. I decree over you that this week will be your best week yet in the name of Jesus. Because God calls us to progress. So week after week, it gets better. This week will be better than last week. It will be better than 2 weeks ago. It's going to be greater and more honorable than weeks before in the name of Jesus. This week will be your best week yet in the name of Jesus, like never before. The odds are not stacked against you. The devil thinks they are stacked against you, but I'm telling you, God is allowing them to be stacked for you. You will step upon every odd that's coming against you this week, and it will propel you forward into the things that God has for you. In the name of Jesus, the odds come and begin to declare. Say, the odds are stacked for me this week. There's no problem. There's no challenge that I face this week that I'm not able to overcome. By the wisdom of the Holy Ghost, by the mind of Christ, I have overcome. I am more than a conqueror. So declare that this morning, that this week I received the wisdom of the ancients to deal with every challenge, to deal with every issue that I need to tackle in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Every issue, every challenge, every circumstance, whatever it is that Satan is lining up against me, it is going to work for me. The Bible says, for if the princes of this world have known, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. If Satan had known, he will not bring against you what he's trying to bring against you this week, because they're going to become stepping stones to launch you forward. God's going to use them as paths for launching you forward. In the name of Jesus, God's using the odds that will seem to be used of the devil against you this week to work out an even greater lifting for you in the name of Jesus. Satan will be biting his finger by the end of this week. He'll be biting his finger in regret by the end of this week. Oh, ow! How did he go past? How did she escape? What did we do? How did we lose out? Because the Lord God Almighty has taken over your mind. You will not reason like a natural man this week. You will not think like a natural being this week. But supernaturally, you're going to be reasoning out every situation. And the Lord will give you progress. And the Lord will give you victory. In the name of Jesus. Ripasa talabaka tushkedebo. Some of you, that you may have been going round and round in circles. It seems like you've been going round and round in circles. It seems like, oh God, when is there going to be a shift? Welcome to your week of shift. This week is your week of shift. In the name of Jesus. This week is your week of shift. This week is shifting for you. So declare right and say, this week is shifting for me. In the name of Jesus. This week is shifting for me. I will no longer run around in circles. Just like God told Moses in Deuteronomy chapter 2, from verse 2 to 3 and verse 7. He says, the Lord spoke unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you northward. Northward means turn you into the presence of God. Turn you into the way that God has earmarked for you. This week, you're turning northward. Northward is your portion in the name of Jesus. Whatever northward is in your circumstance, that's where the Lord is taking your eyes and taking your mind and your spirit. The Lord is saying this week is shifting for you as you turn northwards in the name of Jesus. He says in verse 7, it says, for the Lord your God had blessed you in all the works of your hand. He knows you're walking through this great wilderness. Some of us have been through wildernesses. We've been going round and round in a circle. The Lord is saying he's blessing the works of your hand. The wilderness season is about to end. You're about to cross over. You're about to break forth. You're about to break through in the name of Jesus. And this will be significant in your breaking through in the mighty name of Jesus. It says, for you walk through this great wilderness, these 40 years, the Lord had been with you and you've lacked nothing. Look at that. In the wilderness, God makes sure that you've lacked nothing. How much more when he's about to release you into his abundance? There shall be no lack in your life this week. So come and begin to declare that my face is turned towards the divine places of opportunity. Because when you face northwards, according to the order of the Spirit, it is a place of divine opportunity. It is a place of open doors. It is a position of favor. It is a place of promotion. It is a place of increase. It is a place of growth. It is a place of development. It is a place of establishment. So begin to declare, I am established this week. I am promoted this week. I am growing this week. I have increase this week. I have opened doors this week. I am highly favored this week. Doors of opportunity are opening up for me this week. In the name of Jesus, I will be led to places of growth and development. Declare that right now. In the name of Jesus, declare that you will not lack the oil of gladness. Oh, declare that the oil of gladness that's setting you up above your peers in wisdom and understanding is alighting upon you this week in the name of Jesus. I receive the oil of gladness because I've loved righteousness and I have hated iniquity. Therefore, the Lord has anointed me with an oil of gladness above my fellows. You have been raised by the oil of gladness above your fellows. Your business has been raised
with the oil of
gladness above your fellows. Your children have been raised by the oil of gladness above their fellows. In the name of Jesus. This week, you're experiencing a rising above your fellows. You're experiencing wisdom beyond the norm. Unusual wisdom, unusual favor, unusual revelation and understanding is your portion this week in the name of Jesus. And that means that you're rising above every scheme, every manipulation, every distraction strategy from the pit of hell. You're rising above them. In the name of Jesus, this week you're 10 steps ahead of the devil. That as he's cooking up, you're sniffing it out and you're dealing with it. In the name of Jesus, oh, declare that you're rising above every obstacle. You're crossing over every valley. You're parting every Red Sea or every Jordan River. In the name of Jesus, through the enabling power of the Holy Ghost, you are climbing. You are rising. You are moving forward in the name of Jesus Christ. Paul began to declare in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 from verse 7 to 10 about the wisdom of God, a great wisdom that's beyond, that's above. And it's this same wisdom that created the heavens and the earth. It's this same wisdom that said, let there be and there was. That's the kind of wisdom you're operating by this week in the name of Jesus. The wisdom that saw the light and said it was good. That's the kind of wisdom you're operating by. The wisdom that separated the light from the darkness. The wisdom that named every animal and every object on the face of this earth. That's the kind of wisdom that you're operating by. And whatever Adam named it, that was the name thereof. God did not contest it because he was operating by higher wisdom. The wisdom of Almighty. That's the wisdom you're operating by this week. That's the wisdom that's come upon you. The wisdom of the ancient. The wisdom that knows the root of everything. The wisdom that understands how to navigate through this world. The wisdom that understands how to navigate in the spirit and accomplish all that God has for it. That's the kind of wisdom that you're operating by this week in the name of Jesus. Look at what Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 from verse 7. He said, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory. The hidden wisdom. And God ordained it before the world, before he created the world. God already ordained this wisdom to your glory. Come and declare right now that I'm operating by this wisdom that has been ordained for my glory. I'm operating by that wisdom this week in the name of Jesus. God forbid, I will never operate below that wisdom this week in the name. This wisdom that God has ordained for my glory, I step into it this week. I operate by it this week. In the name of Jesus. Look at what it says in verse 6. It says, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Hallelujah. Demons can't understand this wisdom. Demons can't comprehend this wisdom. So they think they're trying to destroy you, not knowing that they're lifting you up. Hallelujah. They think they're trying to pull you down. They think they're trying to stop you, knowing that they're propelling you forward towards the fulfillment of the destiny that God has for you. So declare that this week I operate by this wisdom. I operate by this understanding. I operate by this revelation. I operate by this divine enablement of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. He says in verse 9, it says, but as it is written, I have not seen, nor hear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man. The things that God has prepared for them that love him. No man understands what God has prepared for you. No man can comprehend what God has prepared for you. Howbeit, it says, but God had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. So the wisdom is no longer hidden. It is now revealed. Come and begin to declare that I'm operating by the revealed wisdom of God. For this time, the revealed wisdom of God that has been revealed, that has been ordained unto my glory. Indeed, I will walk in glory. I will reign in glory. I will move in glory. I will operate in glory through the wisdom that has been ordained unto my glory before the world was created. In the name of Jesus, by the Holy Spirit, I receive a revelation. I receive an understanding. And I operate by this wisdom. In the name of Jesus. He says, but God had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. Says, for the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. And so begin to declare that the deep things of God, the deep things of the wisdom of God, I connect with them this week. I connect with the deep things of God. So I am 10 steps ahead of the devil in the name of Jesus. So declare that this week you will not be ignorant of what has been reserved for your progress this week in Jesus' name. I will not be ignorant of what has been reserved and revealed for my progress in the name of Jesus. Declare that you receive with clarity of mind every revelation that has been reserved for my progress this week. I receive with clarity now every revelation that has been released for my progress this week in the name of Jesus. I receive it, Lord. I function according to the order and the patterns of the Spirit. This week, in the name of Jesus, I receive it, Lord. Decree that this week you will function according to God's ordained purpose for you. There is purpose for this week. I will function. You will function. Your home will function. Your children will function. Your businesses will function. Your life will function. Your spiritual work will function according to the purpose of God for you this week. In the name of Jesus Christ, decree that every organ in your body will function according to purpose. Every organ, my eyes will function according to purpose. My mind will function according to purpose. My mouth will function according to purpose. My hands will function according to purpose. My heart will function according to purpose. In the name of Jesus Christ, I will function this week according to that purpose. According to purpose. Declare that right now. Declare that right now. No room for the enemy. The Bible says you resist him steadfastly in the faith. No room for Satan. The Bible says give no room to Satan. We are not giving any demon any room this week in the name of Jesus, because we function according to purpose. We are functioning this week according to purpose in the name of Jesus. Masa Kalabakatuski. Come and declare this week. Declare that this week that every foolishness of Satan sent against you will be overturned by the abundance of God's wisdom flowing from within you in the name of Jesus. Remember that Satan is not wise. He is foolish. But he tries to present his foolishness as wisdom. So every foolishness of Satan that is sent against you this week, declare that they are overturned by the abundance and the overflow of the wisdom of God Flowing from within you. In the name of Jesus. Masaka labagadu. Zekekekekekeke. Rapakatushkerebo. Zinderabashikerebo. Rekekekekeke. I operate by the wisdom of the ancients. This week in the name of Jesus. I operate by the wisdom of the ancients. The Bible says, because I have the wisdom of the ancients, I know more than my teachers. I know more than my teachers. I am advanced beyond this realm. I am advanced beyond this natural realm. The supernatural, is what I operate by. In the name of Jesus. Come on, speak that for right now. Speak it for right now. Let it settle in your spirit. Let it settle in your spirit. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Father, we worship you. Father, we give you praise. In the name of Jesus. Masata labrahandeski. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. And as we round up this morning, I want to begin to thank God that there is restoration coming for you. That indeed, as the Lord has declared, that restoration is your portion this week in the name of Jesus. I am so strong in my spirit. Restoration coming for someone this week. Restoration in the name of Jesus. Restoration in those areas. In those things, it is your portion in the name of Jesus. Restoration, restoration in Jesus' name. Lord, we honor you and we bless your name. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Father, we worship you. Father, we bless your name. We give you all the praise and all the glory. For in Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And as we approach the communion this morning, sealing up every utterance that we have declared, I'd like you to pick up your bread with a deeper meaning this morning. Mm. With a mind that's set on restoration. Mm. That by this communion, every force in heaven that's needed to make sure that restoration manifests for you this week, in the coming weeks, if money is what you need, money is manifesting for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Restoration. That as you pick up the bread.
Yes.
And as you declare your thanks unto God.
Hallelujah.
For that which God has done.
Hallelujah.
In your life.
Yes, Lord.
For that which God has done through the sacrifice, the breaking of the body of Jesus for your sake.
Yes.
He didn't break it for himself, he broke it for you.
Yes.
He didn't shed his blood for himself, he shed it for you. And so we're maximizing that right now. Say, Father, thank you for the restoration that comes with the sealing of the communion this morning.
Yes.
That indeed, every force in heaven that's required is set in motion.
Yes.
As we conclude with this communion this morning.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, we bless you.
Yes.
For in Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. You can eat this morning.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
In like manner, you can pick up your cup.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, we thank you for the representation of your blood that was shed this morning. That was not this morning, but that was shed well over 2,000 years ago. But that we're partaking of this morning.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
The shed blood of Jesus.
Yes.
That announces victory.
Yes.
That announces that it is finished.
Yes.
Your restoration is settled this morning. As you partake in the shed blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Nothing can defy the blood of Jesus. Nothing can stop the blood from achieving its purpose.
Mm.
If the blood did not fail to deliver you from the hands of Satan, it will not fail to deliver your restoration.
Hallelujah.
In this season, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If the blood did not fail to save you and to redeem you back to God, the blood will not fail to settle your restoration.
Mm.
In this season, this week and weeks to come. In Jesus' name. And so, Father, we partake of the blood. Healing is settled.
Mm.
Lifting is settled. Promotion is settled. Abundance is settled. Wisdom is settled. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Restoration is settled. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
And we give you all the glory. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can drink this morning.
Amen.